We know that wisdom tooth extraction is a very common procedure. We also know that often prescribing opioids for wisdom tooth is a matter of routine practice. But what we don't know is what happens after somebody has their wisdom teeth pulled and gets an opioid prescription. We don't know if people go on to continue filling opioid prescriptions long after we would expect. And that's the gap we were really trying to fill here with this study. This is a unique population to look in because opioids may not even be needed for this procedure. Opioids should typically be used for breakthrough pain when we're talking about after surgical procedures or dental procedures, and they should usually be for backup if your pain's not controlled with other medications like NSAIDs or nonsteroidal anti-inflammatories. So we're essentially looking at potentially a discretionary prescription. And an opioid prescription should not be taken lightly. Taking that prescription home is not necessarily safe. There are risks of addiction. There are risks of overdose. There are risks that they can go and get diverted to other users. Best advice is to talk to your dentist and to be informed about the risks. There are different ways to treat pain. It may involve opioids, it may not. But even if opioids are offered, ask questions about not only when to take them, but when to stop taking them, how to stop taking them, how to store them in a locked location where you know that your kids won't get into them. I hope that providers and clinicians think twice before they prescribe. Providing care for your patients isn't necessarily about taking all of that pain away, but it's about treating it safely and appropriately. If we know that NSAIDs treat the pain just as well as the opioids, but opioids place them at higher risk, then it's really important we start to really critically think about what the evidence shows and what the risk we're putting our patients at is.